Hey, I'm Aaron Pirett, and welcome to another Scott Equipment Company Pro Tip video. Today, I have Philip Hart with me from Joulin. Philip, how you doing?
Good, sir.
One of the things I wanted to show people is how I've challenged you before in I've got a product, I've got an idea, and Philip, I basically want you to run with it. So today, what I've got here came right out of our shop, bag of fittings. It's kind of heavy, pretty good size box, probably got 100 fittings here, a little bit of weight. And what I want to do is I want to be able to tell my customer what we're going to use, how we're going to use it, and why we're going to use it. And normally what I do is come by, hey, Philip, how you doing? And here you go.
Drop the product off.
Show me your magic.
Right. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to ask a little bit about the project, obviously. Let's assume in this situation, the bags are the product is being put in the box, and then the box is being basically taped, and all we need to do is handle the box itself. If that's the case, then we'll do our best to find a solution. In this situation, let's assume that the box was maybe it's hot glued on the flaps or something to that effect, and it's really, really loose. This is really the worst thing that could happen because the capacity goes away because you can shear the foam.
This is a terrible application here. Like, there's no tape, there's no glue, we're uneven, it's heavy,
yes.
It's rectangular in size, so it's not even, you know, of normalcy. So what are you going to do? What would you do for me?
So in this situation, what I want to do is I want to try to capture all four corners because that's where your rigidity and your structure is. And your capacity is going to be coming from this gripper itself because we're going to have a check valve gripper on a porous product that's heavy. And so what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to have as much capacity as possible. So even when I'm moving it around there, I can feel the product inside shifting, which actually is even worse when you're thinking about your moments of inertia for the robot and so on and so forth. So you wouldn't even see that much motion stop and go. So, but even then, the foam is able to comply to the top of the layer. We're able to pull vacuum on the layer, keep it nice and tight so that it's rigid.
So this is where in your lab, you actually video stuff, you actually take pictures, you actually send recommendations, and yes. You would get back with me on this gripper, this size, this pressure, and we could turn it back over to the customer in a quote, a part number with a drawing in CAD, which
That's
we
exactly
all,
right.
all know the engineers have to have right now.
Yes.
Folks, if you're looking for a gripper or a gripper company that can help you get further on your EOT project, let me know. I'd be happy to get together with Philip. Thank you again, Philip.
Yes,
appreciate it. Let us know.